Stephanie at rehab. And Lord, I just ask that they will do something with that testimony if they don't know you. And we thank you for the seed he's planted in all of us, and it will keep coming up.
Yes.
Until the Lord comes back. I guess he's already seen Mom.
Yeah.
He knows he'll kiss her more than she wants to be kissed. He always did. But let them just, I don't know what the relationships are like there, but I know they're going to talk a lot.
Yes.
And find comfort in each other. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Amen, amen.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
You're done.
I'll leave
it right out there.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, let me
telling you to do is cry out to Jesus, say, Jesus, save me. And then trust that he begins to say to you,
may it be upon the people of God, ideas, witty inventions, favor,
there you go,
promotions.
We're here about to get crunched from the air. Rest in peace, Papa. Kern, start jogging at least. Corinne, you made it.
Yep. Leave us alone with the Wi-Fi. I gotta like send something or email.
Where do you want to eat?
I'm gonna write you anything.
She's here.
Who I got with me. It's Corinne.
Hi.
It's Corinne. Would you like to say something in Russian?
No, I'm not. Not
that's Vidanya.
Sakashiba.
Sakashiba. What?
Doesn't that mean thank you?
No. Spasiba.
Oh, spasiba, yeah. Spasiba. I saw that in a Korean drama.
Say Slava Bogu. Praise
yeah,
God.
Take a selfie in front of the poly, y'all.
All right, say closing remarks. I don't mean say that, just say something to end the video.
To y'all, happy birthday, Karen and Karen Rebecca. Happy birthday to y'all.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, we both blew it out.
Are we going to sing to you too?
I said happy
everybody
birthday, y'all.
Says Kara
and Corinne.
What? Everybody say Kara and Corinne.
All right.
Say
so
Corinne.
All right. Pass the brownies
hi,
around.
Hi, Corinne, Rebecca, are you 20?
Wait.
Cut edit to everybody getting.
I need mom. I'll get this one.
There you go.
This one. Here, mommy.
Okay.
And your daddy both ate like two family size packs.
That's what you need.
In like a weekend.
Mm-hmm.
I know.
What are all these little mice crawling around us?
Keep Matthew close and your Jesus closer. My third one. Hopefully this one doesn't. English.
That's a cute card.
Thank you.
Getting everybody.
I know. Hey, Danny. How are you?
Please go right ahead.
Hi.
You've seen good work in the
house.
Tell me about this.
Little.
Last time.
I called
him. He was upset.
Yeah.
And I said, "Well, I said, great. I thank you for this family.
Thank you, Jesus.
I thank you that the foundation of their lives is in you, Jesus Christ. And I pray today as we enter into this special memorial service, Lord, that it will speak to the hearts and lives of each individual as present. May they all be challenged to follow you every step of the way.
Yeah.
I pray, Lord, that when we leave here after a while, we'll leave here not as a people who have no hope, but we'll leave here rejoicing in the fact that we know where it is today, and that we're on our way there. Now, Father, we place this family in your hands. Bless Pastor Dan and Son as they share in this service today. May your anointing rest upon them.
Yeah.
May the joy of the Lord fill their hearts. In Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Well, as much practice as you can get at a Bible college. I'll just say, it's an honor for my first official officiation. You can probably tell it's the first. But getting to represent the grandsons of this man, Edward Lynn Woods, is... You know, I don't, maybe in heaven I'll be able to express. But the way that he expressed himself on earth with a finesse that you wouldn't expect, understanding what types of things that he overcame on earth is the type of finesse that I would love to. You know, with what we're dealt with, earth, it's only through the capabilities of the Holy Spirit that open up ways to handle, not react, but respond to things. And if you ever sat down with Papa, or however you knew him, you'd understand just from what he accomplished with raising two sons in the 1960s and 70s. that it was someone with such a gentle spirit, and it's such a fruit of the Holy Spirit of gentleness.
Amen.
That it's a testament to what you need to live life. You know, I'm about just a journey where it's going to require. Saying that, I'm going to read 2 Timothy 2:20. But in a great house, and we have a great house, speaking of the kingdom of God, but in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and silver, but also wood and clay, some for honor and some for dishonor. Therefore, if anyone cleanses himself from the latter of wood and clay, he will be a vessel for honor, sanctified, and useful for the master, prepared for every good work. You know, despite how Papa spoke sometimes, Jesus, just again, what he went through, it was a miracle. He wasn't, you know, he's a lot stronger. You could understand. But disregarding the way that he sometimes expressed himself, man, he did express himself with sincerity all the time. Right? And you know, you know who he is. You know you can trust him. After a lot of that's attributed to Nanny's life too. Mm-hmm. And after Nanny passed, he became the number one person that I spoke to about a lot of things. He probably but Nanny taught him well. But you know, things, it's all joy. It's all joyous times because the necessary darkness that's in the world, you know, from living in a corrupt world, you know, we were never built for sin, we were never built for death. We were never designed with a purpose to have things, unholy things, enter in. But that's why Jesus needed to come. And if you cleanse yourself of the things, the youthful lusts of this world, and the things that try to jump at you for attention, momentary things, it says that you will cleanse yourself and become a vessel of gold and silver, sanctified, used for honor, and useful for the master in every good work that he has prepared for you. And that was one of the number one things that came along with Papa's gentleness. He really wanted to make sure that he was not making anyone being put at a disadvantage, or that any action, any word, anything that he could ever say, he would sometimes in the middle of the conversation just say, "Oh God, if I had said anything wrong whatsoever," you know, he wanted to make sure, say, "Actually, don't listen to me. If it's for me, listen to it. If it's the word of God, then we can know." It's that kind of finesse with dealing with everything in life that I hope to possess to a greater extent. Because I certainly need that. And having grown up really alongside him for a long time, especially with, you know, we know that the world is corrupt, so things are dealt to us all the time. They're not the plan of God, but he knows how to turn them into something awesome. And he turned this pandemic for me personally into 7 months of just different types of preparation that I couldn't have gotten anywhere else. I'm spending a lot of time with him, forcing him to go on hikes, and eating and watching football, just hanging out, going over the Bible, reading him missionary stories, showing him videos about the people that he got to help influence, to being led unto salvation, and just in my short amount of time in Belarus. And the biggest thing that I can take away is when I came back, and he finally, something came. Something, you know, the Holy Spirit told him, okay, he's for real. This is what I have set for him to do. So you'll have to, he sat down and told me that, you know, I'm going to have to acknowledge this now because you've gone and you're going to go back. And it's time. There's nothing I can do about it. I'm really excited for you to go, but, you know, he didn't want to actually see me go. Like I said, it's just a good time to go. And so, all that preparation is being used. And this is the only way I can account for it, because it's myself, but everyone that have them, and this is just from having a relationship with Christ as well, that testify all these personal things. And I would never stand up here and say that my story was higher than yours or anything like that, because you don't want my story, you don't want anyone else's, you know, the way that the Lord can such uniquely show you things that only He knows about you intimately.
Right.
It's exactly the story that you want. And how far you want to go with that, it's up to you. Now cleanse yourself from the wood and the clay of the world, and you'll be useful to the Master. Made gold and silver, the highest vessels in the house, and the balls in your court. It's when a verse starts off with therefore, you gotta understand what it's there for. It's you have to respond.
That's right.
You know, and it's all I know how to do is present the Lord with vessels. He knows how to fill them up. In the moments that I got to sow in, just a being with Him, and you could just be with Him, and it was fulfilling. And you would learn stuff and glean stuff. And again, just that sort of gentleness is what I want to be able to grow in. Because, I mean, Nanny would call me a beautiful mess, and that's sweet. It's really enjoyable. And I was work. But, you know, we all are in our different ways. But the way that we get, again, not to react, but to respond to the things that the world throws our way, you're never going to know. You're never going to know until it comes to the moment where now He has all the same finesse without any of the worry.
Yeah.
And I can say beyond a shadow of any doubt, the peace that passes all understanding, Papa now knows with full strength how much He meant to everyone individually in all their hearts. And that's where the joy comes from, because we all get to represent not just Him and not just Nanny, but the marriage, the family legacy, with whatever missions field that God calls you to do. I don't care if it's two streets down your house, or two time zones away, or 2,000 miles away, whatever the Lord has set for you, can glean with the same sort of finesse that Papa mysteriously had, and you can show that in your journey to be useful for every good work. So Papa, you fully know how much we all love you, and I hope that we can all properly convey with as much conviction of how you expressed your love to all of us. He would never gossip. If he mentioned someone's name, he would always come with, "I don't know them, but I pray for them." You know, and that's another lesson that we can have. So in closing, I'm just thankful to God that I got picked and selected to be part of this great house. For all the relatives, for everybody that's under the sound of my voice, as we close today in this building, celebrating the life of Edward Lynn Woods, I'd like for you to search your soul for anything that you are wanting to either get changed out, replaced, repaired, restored. The only reason we're able to come together with such joy is all the promises of God. So Lord, thank you for all of the 22 years that I got to be with my grandfather. Thank you for all the years that everyone else got to experience the joy of what it was like to be with somebody that was from the 1930s. Thank you for all the wisdom that came out of conversations, with all the laughs, with all the remarks, with all the Bible studies. Thank you, Lord, that there's people under the sound of my voice that had a relationship just as you intended, like I had with my grandfather. Thank you that any relationship that needs to be restored through your grace, through your forgiveness, through your peace, is restored under Jesus' name. Thank you that we're able to completely go by with what we were shown as an example from someone all the way from knowing Papa his whole life, or if you just met him once. Lord, he always prayed for those people. We're thankful for the future that our family holds, not just the Woods family or the extended families, but the family of the unshakable kingdom. Thank you that we're always translated and that we're always given up and sanctified, set apart. The things that the world tries to throw at us, we know that we can carry your finesse and the way to react and respond instead of react. So once again, thank you, Lord, for the marriage that we got to see, 65 days, years, 3 weeks, and the 3 bonus years that we got to spend with a different kind of papa. Just the way it was ready. He was ready not only to see you, but I was ready for him to see the potential of his final years on earth fulfilled with Papa. You know your wisdom within your marriage is going to inspire people. And the last words, thank you, Lord, from the last time that I got to see him. With the recent passing of grandparents, I was always traveling, wasn't able to see them the last time, but I thank you for the gift that I got to see him finally on his last day, being able to have visitors. Thank you for the moments that we spent just reminiscing, encouraging him as they were about to take him away, that he has the authority and the ability. Just like we all have the authority and the ability, God has set things apart for us in every dark corner of the world, hidden treasures that only have your names on them. Someone's salvation can rest in the balance of you stepping out, concerning the help, all those that we come to contact with. And the final thing that we got to talk about before we got the news is just the way that children deserve to open up gifts on Christmas, and that he would want to give towards giving orphans presents, and just the selflessness that he still saw the need. Lord, inspire us. Take more of us out of our own selves. I don't want to walk around being Asher. I don't want to walk around. We don't want that for ourselves, God. We're thankful that the example that we got to see, however long that was, one day for 60 plus years, experiencing what this marriage and what this man was, we're thankful that they live on because we live on. You're never meant to die. You're never designed that way. But what eternal life is, John 17:3, eternal life is knowing Jesus Christ, the Son, and God the Father who sent him. It doesn't start, Papa's eternal life didn't start a few days ago. It started the day that he met God. So thank you for more grace and more abundance in grace so that we may live out our eternal life today, yesterday, 20 years ago, 10 minutes from now, the way that we get to walk around eternally in the flesh. We're thankful for the promise that once we do die, our body is planted in the rebirth of the new body. If Papa and Amy were so beautiful, and this is just their seed, and how different an acorn looks from an oak tree, we can only imagine, with our limited human thinking, the beauty that they are experiencing. So once again, thank you. Amen. So this concludes the service indoors. Bundle up because everything's going to continue outside in the Roanoke area. Thank
I appreciate y'all from the floor.
Oh.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. Kevin.
I'm ready.
Hi, girls.
Ashley.
Yeah.
I was fine until
you... Okay, thank you so much.
Jesus, go help.
Good.
Oh, there it is.
What did you say?
What? Just now?
Yeah.
Oh, I said group hug.
No, to me.
Oh, I said I was fine. Like, I was set up here until you were literally, like, stood up.
Is it a rose?
Like, yeah.
First time I looked at you.
Yeah.
That's sweet. What do you want to say, Aubrey?
Oh.
What do you want to say?
Asher did it so good. We all did. It was one of the best funerals we've ever been to. Most beautiful funeral service I've ever attended, Mom. Now, I don't know if you can get Facebook. Does Chrissy get it at the house? It's, you can watch the service. And I'll have to tell you.
Connor.
Love you guys.
Are we good?
Stick up, stick up, stick up.
It is.
Okay. Jameson, look.
That's where that Chipotle is that we've done. We've driven through it all the time.
Yeah.
We just don't hang around.
They live in Sharpsburg.
Go to Dollywood.
Bye, Jameson. Good meeting you. Oh, say hi to the camera. Say hi to the camera.
Hi.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Love you.
Good seeing you again.
And if I'm serious, if you're ever passing through, be afraid to get our numbers from your mom.
Okay.
We'll have you for dinner.
Thank you.
Bye, Jameson.
And next time we'll take you guys somewhere. We'll go to downtown Greenville.
Okay.
Plans.
I know, but this is important.
Thanks. Love you all. Bye, Jameson.
Bye. Let's try it out. Watch how quickly it can remove pollutants from the air. Impressive. And at 23 decibels, it makes no more noise.
What,
our Christmas service last year?
Really? Yeah. That's a bit of music, yeah. Amazing.
That service was very impactful.
I love the little fire.
The baby Jesus said that was supposed to be.
Bye!
Merry Christmas! Christmas.
Are you okay?
Well, Aubrey, I'm gonna leave for Ukraine soon.
Fine.
Yeah. I'm gonna leave the country. And this is my last video I'll have with you for God knows how long. So what do you want to say? To me. Look at me. What do you want to say?
I love you.
I love you too. I'll miss you. Yes. I told Aubrey the same thing. I'm leaving. I don't know when I'll have a video of you next. You want to say something to me? Look at me. Look at me. Bye.
Bye.
I'm leaving next week. I love you. I miss you.
Bye. Oh, my chocolate foot.
Wow.
Wave to the camera, everybody. Kara.
What are you cooking? John, is it...
It's a good start.
Yes!
About dang time, boy.
John, man, we came from Grandma. I have my voice. I'm all right this way, Grandma.
Wait, everyone. Remember what Jesus said. We will praise God with singing, and we will honor him with thanksgiving. I'll just finish. Still going.
All right,
I'll just finish the deed. Two. Wait. Three. Yeah.
Amen.
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 Who's ready?
Yeah, buddy. Wait, you're actually eating cookies.
Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Spasiba Jesus.
I'm glad to say hello to you, honey. This is Paw-Paw. Asher's with me here at the hospital. I've had a little tough luck, but thank you for praying for me. And I feel like I know you. When I don't, but maybe someday I will. God bless you, and thank you for praying for me. Bye-bye.
No idea.
It's from all of us.
It's already begun.
Oh, boy. Oh.
Shall we pass the tissue?
Get it out, Papa. Get it out. Here, Papa. We'll get her out. Move the bag. Thanks. Thanks, Adam.
It's a Nanny pillow.
It's a pillow pet. I got a good angle.
Aw.
Are you going to take it home?
Tell her how happy you are.
I'm happy, so happy. And Asher's telling me about you. And I just love it. I just heard some wonderful things. And I miss you. Edward Lynn Woods. See, I don't remember when I found this. I don't remember seeing it before.
Rick
left. Edward Lynn Woods. It don't say deer. We're going to smudge it, you know, and none of that mess. Thank you for being you. We have had many wonderful times together. We have also had to share sorrows along the journey, but God has always been with us. Amen. My, what great two sons we have. and all the grandchildren we have to enjoy and love, and daughters and all. With all my love, it is Jim Wood. I love that.